Hey folks, Sean here from Grafana Labs, and I'm excited to announce Grafana 12.1 is officially out, and while it's not a major release, it is full of things you'll actually use, so buckle up. Now this release includes smarter alerting, smoother dashboards, some long-requested quality of life upgrades, and even a new tool that helps keep your Grafana instances healthy. So let's start with what will help you and your team avoid the classic, hey, Grafana broke and nobody noticed until a blank dashboard and error popped up. The Grafana Advisor, which was marked experimental in the Grafana 12 launch, is now officially here in public preview and is designed to run periodic checks on your instances to identify issues like broken data source connections, needed upgrades for plugins, and misconfigurations, then surfaces them all in a centralized view to address quickly. You can view the Advisor sort of like an easy health check engine for your Grafana setup, with the powerful ability to hook into Grafana's LLM plugin, where you can bring your own LLM API key from Google, OpenAI, Claude, and have the Advisor diagnose issues for you. So if you're an admin, definitely start to use it and give us feedback on how we can make this even better. OSS users will need to flip on the Grafana Advisor toggle, but Claude users will see the Advisor by default. Grafana 12.1 introduces a new regression analysis transformation. This lets you apply a mathematical model, whether that be linear or polynomial, to any dataset in Grafana. Why does this matter, you may ask? Because now you can predict values at points in time that don't even exist in your original data. This is super handy for when you're trying to estimate missing data, identify trends, or just build smoother visualizations overall. It updates on every data refresh too, so it's dynamic, it's not just a static snapshot. Basically, you get a smarter lens of your data without having to export it to Excel or break out a Jupyter notebook. My Python friends will totally get that one. More on variables, 12.1 also brings a new way to make dashboards more interactive with custom variables and visualization actions. Essentially, instead of hard coding everything, users can now input values in real time, like entering a problem description when opening a support ticket or setting a target temperature in a control panel. It is a subtle feature, but it opens a door to a bit of API auto remediation and more dynamic workflows. Then we have added server configurable QuickTime ranges, which were designed for admins to now be able to define custom presets for the dashboard time picker. So maybe your team always looks at the last 24 hours or this week within a dashboard. You can now bake that logic right into your server config as code. Shout out to Chris Hodges from the community for contributing this feature. This is a huge win for all of us users of Grafana, and we always love to see ideas and solutions coming from the community. And finally, for anyone working with financial data, Grafana 12.1's enhanced currency formatting now gives you the option to display exact numbers, instead of abbreviating it to something like 1.24 million. All you have to do is just click the currency financial dollar format to get precise, readable numbers. And yes, it supports suffixes too, like pounds, dollars, yen, and so forth. But we aren't always just staring at dashboards. We also use alerts to be a bit more proactive at catching issues. So let's talk about what's new in Grafana alerting. Now, for those who have managed hundreds or thousands of alert rules, you know the old view could get a little sluggish, per se. Grafana 12.1, however, introduces a redesigned page with faster performance through pagination, regardless of how many rules you've got. You can now toggle between two different distinct views, a grouped view, which shows rules organized, and a flat list view, which shows the status of alerts, whether it's firing or not, making it easy to find or bulk edit your rules. Last, if you're migrating from Prometheus, there's good news. You can now import alert rules from YAML files directly into Grafana Managed Alerting, even if you're not using a ruler. You just upload the file in the UI, and boom, your rules are in. Now, this wouldn't be a Grafana release without some improvements the Big Ten or family of data sources supported. With 12.1, there's a big win for security teams all around the world when it comes to BigQuery and service accounts. If you're unfamiliar with what service accounts are in Google Cloud, you can think of it like this. Instead of handing someone the keys to the kingdom, you say, hey, for the next 10 minutes, you can act like the king, but you gotta show me your ID at the gate. Normally, when Grafana queries BigQuery, you authenticate using a service account key, which is a JSON file. It's sort of a static secret, right? If that file leaks, it's game over. The attackers have full access. But with impersonation, you don't give Grafana a key to the target service account directly. Instead, you authenticate Grafana using a less privileged identity. That identity is allowed to impersonate the actual BigQuery service account. Access to BigQuery only works if impersonation succeeds, and that requires proper IAM permissions. So now, if a Grafana account token gets stolen, an attacker still can query BigQuery unless they can also impersonate the target account, which they can without IAM. Additionally, on the SSO side of the house, Grafana now supports Entra Workload Identity, formerly known as Azure AD. If you're running Grafana in Azure and using federated credentials, this simplifies the OAuth flow and tightens up security for you, all while reducing your overhead. So shout out to Mahigwa from the community for contributing this one. This is truly open source at its best, right? So yeah, Grafana 12.1 is definitely cleaning up and introducing a few new features that improve the user experience. All of these features are available right now in Grafana OSS and cloud. So if you're not already running 12.1, go check it out, test what's new. And as always, what's most important, let us know what you like and what's not working. You can find full release notes at grafana.com/docs or check out the Grafana 12.1 What's New blog post, which will be linked below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next release.